Hello everybody, Terry Terry back again with another video, and today's video guys is going to be about to previewing this ATP Tour Finals in London 2020 between the world number 3 Dominic Thiem versus the world number 4 Daniil Medvedev. Both of these two guys have taken out two of the big three members. Medvedev took out Rafa in three sets, and Dominic Thiem took out Novak Djokovic in three sets after being down in the third set, love 4, and did a remarkable, impeccable comeback to win that third set tiebreak 7-5. And now they will face each other for the fifth time. I believe they had to add this 3-1 to Dominic Thiem. And last time they faced each other was earlier this year in the semifinals US Open, where Dominic actually won in straight sets. But it was a brutal close. Dominic even himself admitted that that was his most brutal straight sets victory in his career. I believe Dominic won 6-2 the first set, and the second and the third set he won them in tiebreaks, 7-6, 7-6. No surprise there. Dominic winning tiebreaks in 2020 season. We have heard about that before. So now they will face each other here in the NITO ATP Finals in London. Who will win this one? What will happen? Guys, of course this match is not easy to predict. For God's sakes, the world number 3 is facing the world number 4. Of course, it is not easy predicting. Yeah, Dominic leads the head-to-head 3-1, but that doesn't mean a thing. That the head-to-head is just only history. Rafa had a 3-love lead against Daniil Medvedev in the head-to-head. But we all saw what happened. Rafa lost. So you will lose sooner or later against somebody, even if you have never defeated him in the past. So the past is an indicator what has happened. It is history what has happened, but it is always a new match. It is always a new challenge. So it always will be a new victory or a new loss for a player. If when I analyze these two players' strengths and weaknesses, let's start with Medvedev. Medvedev's biggest strength, what is his biggest strength? I should say maybe his biggest strength as a tennis player, maybe it is his serve, maybe. But for sure, his serve is one of his biggest strengths in his game. Because he's a tall dude, you don't break his serve that easily, even though Rafa breaks his serve 3 times. One time in the first set and 2 times in the second set. In the third set, Rafa didn't see any single breakpoint opportunity in the semifinal. So the serve for sure is one of Medvedev's biggest strengths. And then his backhand. He doesn't miss a lot of backhands, even though he missed quite a lot of backhands against Rafa actually. He missed more with his backhand than he did with his forehand against Rafa Medvedev. But usually his backhand is rock solid. He can hit that shot in his sleep, Daniil Medvedev. So when you see Daniil Medvedev's game being broken down, usually you see the forehand shot being broken down, not his backhand. So his backhand is rock solid. Then his ability to go from defense to offense. He can go from being defensive on the baseline. He can just take one or two steps further to the baseline and just can create that offensive in a couple of seconds. 3, 4, 5 seconds, he can hurt you with offensive skills. So he can do both. He can both defend really good. He can defend exceptionally good. And he can also hurt you and play close to the baseline and kiss that baseline and penetrate the court with really heavy ground strokes, both from the forehand and especially from the backhand. His backhand is really flat, so it barely bounces indoors. It bounces more, of course, outdoors, especially on clay, and that's why he has not been that successful on clay in his career than Medvedev, because it bounces higher. But indoors, it stays so low. So when he hits his backhand, it is a killer shot, really. It is a killer shot. He can hit it both down the line and he can hit it cross court as well. His forehand, it has little more topspin. For sure, his forehand has more topspin than what his backhand has. His backhand doesn't, more or less, doesn't have any topspin at all. His forehand has little more topspin. So when he hits his deadly shots, Daniil Medvedev, he likes to go for it more with his backhand, and he takes time away with his backhand against his opponents. But he can take time away with his forehand as well. He is dangerous from the both wings, really, both from the forehand and the backhand. But he misses less with his backhand. I get that impression when I see him, at least. He misses less with his backhand what he does with his forehand. Even though that was not the case against Nadal, actually. He missed more with his forehand what he did with his backhand against Nadal. But usually he misses more with his forehand what he does with his backhand. So, his strengths, his serve, his ability to go from defensive to offensive in a couple of seconds. You think you are having him in the corners, but he can just translate defensive to offensive skills and end the point. And the third strength of him is he really moves good to be this tall. He really does. He's not any speed demon a la Diminaur or a la say some of the fastest players we have on tour, Gael Monfils. Gael Monfils is horrible in many things in tennis, in my opinion, especially in consistency. But he can run. He can really run, Gael Monfils. So he's not as fast as Diminaur or Gael Monfils or Djokovic. Djokovic is also really, really fast, to mention some of the fastest players we have on tour. But he moves really good to be this tall, Dan Medvedev. Trust me, he moves exceptionally good. And that's why it is so difficult hitting through him. You could clearly see that in that semifinal match against Nadal as well. Nadal had so trouble hitting through him. And that's why Rafa, more times than not, was playing serve and volley. Because Daniil Medvedev was making Rafa Nadal confused and was frustrating Rafa Nadal. That's what Daniil Medvedev does. He frustrates his opponents. He destroys his opponent's rhythm. He makes his opponents feeling helpless. He is a wall. It is so difficult hitting through this guy. Everything you hit at him, he sends it back at you. With length, with depth, with power as well. Even though he doesn't hit the ball as hard as Dominic does, but he hits the ball harder than Djokovic. Djokovic, what is Djokovic? I don't want to talk about Djokovic because this video is not about Djokovic, but what is Djokovic's biggest weakness? I don't tell what Djokovic's biggest weakness is. At least in his older days, he lacked power. He lacks power, Djokovic. He lacks power. And that's why he does so little winners, Djokovic. He cannot hit through his opponents. And that's why I'm completely convinced that Djokovic will never win French Open ever again. He cannot hit through players on clay, even though that he hits through 95% of the players on clay, because he played the French Open final just a couple of months ago. But he can for sure not hit through Rafa Nadal on clay, Novak Djokovic, because he lacks power. And that is Novak Djokovic's biggest weakness as a tennis player. He cannot create offense in his older days. He could create much more offense when he was younger, but not in his older days. So Medvedev, he is much better than Djokovic in creating offense. At least much better than this version of old Djokovic we are seeing nowadays as 33 years old. But Medvedev doesn't hit the ball as hard as Thiem. Nobody does. But he hits the ball harder than Djokovic, for sure. So Medvedev, he has many strengths. His serve is a big strength. He can create offense and just translate his defensive skills in a couple of seconds to hurt you with his ground strokes, both with forehand and backhand. He moves really good to be a tall dude, and he's really difficult hitting through, except extremely difficult for everyone on the ATP Tour, even for Rafa Nadal. That's why Rafa only did 22 winners against Medvedev in that semifinal match. Only 22 winners. Because he has so troubles hitting through Rafael Nadal. He had so troubles hitting through Medvedev. And that's why Rafa was attempting to go to the net. He was playing serve and volley sometimes. And that's Medvedev, in the end, he wore Rafa Nadal down. He wore him down. That's why he won all the rallies, in the short rallies he won them, the middle rallies he won them, and of course, the longer rallies over 9 shots Medvedev won against Nadal. So Medvedev, he wears his opponents down. He frustrates his opponents because they cannot hit through him. Even though this is indoor hard court and it is much easier hitting through him in a fast surface, but it is still hard hitting through him even in this fast surface. It is just everything comes back at you. Medvedev's biggest weakness, in my opinion, is that he is not consistent throughout the match. He's not consistent. He was not that against Nadal. He just can play 4 or 5 games out of this world tennis, and he just can throw a really bad game and give it to you, like he did that against Nadal in that first set. He just gave that game away to Nadal in that first set, when Rafa won that first set without even playing better than Medvedev. But Medvedev gave a game just to Nadal for free, like a Christmas present. That is Medvedev's big weakness. He can play really sky-high level tennis, but just all of a sudden he can do just a disaster of a game. But he's not alone about that. Many players are like that. Thiem can be like that as well. Tsitsipas can be that as well. Rublev can be that as well. And even Federer can be that as well. We have seen that in the past. And Djokovic also can be that sometimes. Nadal does this least times of all the players in the history of the game, even though that he did a pretty weak performance in the semifinal against Medvedev, one of the weakest performances that I've ever seen Rafa Nadal do, to be quite honest. It reminded me almost the same way as weak performance he did against Fognini in that Monte Carlo match last year, I believe, in 2019. I believe it was semi-final, if I'm not mistaken. It was really, really weak in that match, Nadal against Fognini last year in Monte Carlo, in that semi-final. So this match that Rafa lost against Medvedev, it reminded me of that match. That match against Fognini and this match against Medvedev are the weakest performances that I have ever seen Rafa Nadal do. Anyway, so Medvedev can throw lose games and disaster games all of a sudden after playing 30-40 minutes unbelievable outrageous tennis, but he just can throw that and give that game away for you as Christmas present. So that is Medvedev's biggest weakness. His consistency level is not always sky high, but he has so many strengths. Serve, unbelievable, difficult, and a nightmare hitting through. Can create defensive to offensive in a couple of seconds. And one other thing that I should not forget mentioning, his returns. His returns are remarkably good. They are superb, his returns. For me, he has the second best returns on the ATP Tour at the current moment. Only Djokovic has better returns than him, nobody else. And he has fine. The problem is he has not played like this the entire season. We all know that. He's in a really, really great streak here. And he's in a rhythm here. Won the Paris Masters a couple of weeks ago. And now he's in the final here in London here. And he will face Dominic Thiem. What are Dominic Thiem's biggest strengths? And then after I've told Dominic Thiem's biggest strength, I will give who will win the match and why. Dominic Thiem's biggest strength is his firepower. He has unbelievable firepower. He can hit through anyone in the world. We saw that against Djokovic when he did 50 winners and 39 unforced errors. 11 more winners than unforced errors. So Dominic Thiem, I don't know many players in the world who has more firepower than Dominic Thiem. Probably nobody. When he unleashes those ground strokes from the both wings, it is like he's unleashing a pistol, gun, or a racket, or a rocket, you name it. It is just unbelievable power. You hold your breath when he unleashes those ground strokes, especially his forehand. It is a killing shot, his forehand. Sometimes he can do a lot of unforced with that forehand. His forehand can be up and down. It is not reliable all the time. He can do a lot of unforced. But when it goes in, like it did in that third set tiebreak against Nadal, against Djokovic, when it was love four down, everything went in. So Dominic Thiem, he is a low percentage of tennis player. You don't know where you have him. When he plays his absolute best, when he plays his great mode level or beast mode level, nobody can take him. I swear, nobody. He's unplayable. But he doesn't play beast mode level a lot of times. He doesn't do that. He can do that 3-4 times in a season, not more. But he plays good mode level and great mode level many times. Average level and horrible level, we don't see that crazy many times nowadays from Dominic Thiem. So we don't know what kind of level he will show up against Daniil Medvedev on Sunday. So anyway, Dominic Thiem's firepower is his biggest strength, in my opinion. No question about that. And then his serve is pretty good as well. Not as good as Medvedev's. He doesn't do a lot of services. I think he did 10 services against Djokovic, if I'm not mistaken. And Medvedev did 13 against Nadal. His serve is not as good as Medvedev. For sure, he doesn't land as many first serves in as Medvedev does, because he's shorter than Medvedev. Medvedev has that. He can reach the ball much easier than Dominic, because he's longer, he's taller. He did 64% first serves. He landed for 64% first serves in against Djokovic, which is pretty good to be Dominic. He can sometimes be under 60%. I believe he was 59. He landed 59% first serves in against Nadal. So, but anyway, he doesn't land as many first serves in as Daniel does, because of the obvious reasons I just told in the video. But he does a lot of damage even behind his second serves, because he does a lot of damage in the serve plus points. In the serve plus points, he's really, really dangerous, Dominic Thiem. That's why he wins many of his matches and many of his battles from 0-4 shot rallies. So he doesn't do a crazy many aces. He doesn't land crazy many first serves in, at least not as many first serves in as Daniil Medvedev does, but he does a lot of damage behind those serves, both behind his first serves and both behind his second serves, with his firepower. He hits through all the players with his firepower. You cannot defend his firepower when he is redlining. When he's redlining, he is unstoppable, Dominic Thiem. So his firepower, his biggest strength. His serve is a strength, in my opinion. He has great both first serve and second serve. I really like his second serve. He has a great kick serve. He's great from baseline. He really can handle all the players from the baseline. He is not afraid to go into long exchanges. he has good forehand, exceptional good forehand, not as good backhand. His backhand is solid, is consistent, but it can be consistent. He misses much more with his backhand than what he does with his forehand. But he is good from the baseline. He is not afraid of going into long rallies with all the players in the world. Clay used to be his best surface, but nowadays I'm starting to feel that maybe hard court is, maybe on hard court he is even more dangerous than he is on clay, because on hard courts his firepower helps him hitting through the players even more. Hard courts helps him doing even more winners, because on clay we know the surface is slow. It is the slowest surface we have in tennis, and he cannot do as many winners on clay like he does on hard courts. Because of the surface helps him to do more winners. The surface helps him for that. So he used to be very bad on hard courts, say 4 or 5 years ago, but that is not the case. I feel that he's even more dangerous on hard courts nowadays. So firepower, his service really is a strength. If I go, what is his strength in numbers? First, it is his firepower. No shadow of a doubt about that. Second, Second is his baseline game. He can handle all the plays from the baseline. That's why he has defeated all the big three many times. He has defeated Federer 5 times. He has defeated now Djokovic 5 times. And he has defeated Nadal 6 times. Because he can handle them from the baseline. Especially Djokovic and Nadal. Because we all know Federer is not as good of a baseline player as Djokovic, as Nadal are. And Dominic has defeated Djokovic and Nadal, maybe the greatest baseline players that we have ever seen, many times. And why do you think he has done that? Because he can challenge them from a baseline. So his biggest strength is firepower at the first place, his baseline game in the second place, and his serve is in the third place. These three things are Dominic's biggest strength. Then we come to his weaknesses. In my opinion, his weakness is I'm not crazy in love in his returns. He is not the greatest returner on tour. I just don't think so. He broke Novak's serve only one time in the semifinal, and that was in the first set. I feel that his opponents, they get a lot of free points when they put their first serves in, because Dominic just doesn't do enough with the returns. Sometimes he can shank it, sometimes he can put it on the net, sometimes he can hit it long, but many times he hits his returns short. And when you hit a return short, what will happen? Yeah, it will be an attackable shot, and the players will go into the court and attack his short returns. So he has lost many matches during his career because of his weak returns, in my opinion. Even though he has improved his returns, I must say. He used to be a much worse returner in the past, say 3-4 years ago. But since, say, 2 years ago and further, he has improved his returns tremendously. But still, he's not better returner than Djokovic, and he's not better returner than Medvedev, who, in my opinion, are the best returners in the world at the current moment. And for sure, he's not a better returner than Prime Murray, Dominic Thiem. So his returns are his weakness. Another thing that is a weakness in Dominic's game is that he's pretty fast, I should say, but he's not any speed demon. He's fast, he's for sure not slow. But he's not any speed demon. Is he faster than Medvedev? Yes, probably yes. He's shorter than Medvedev. But not much faster, even though that Medvedev is a taller dude than Dominic. But Dominic is not much faster than Medvedev. So, but his biggest weakness, I should say, it is his his inconsistency level. He can be a unforced error machine, really. If he doesn't hit the ball clean, if he doesn't hit the corners, if he doesn't find these spots, he really can spread out those balls and make a ton of unforced errors. That is his biggest weakness, in my opinion. When I've seen Dominic Thiem lose, he has done a ton of unforced errors. That is his biggest weakness. It is his returns. He's not the fastest player in the world, and he does a lot of unforced errors. And what are Medvedev's biggest weaknesses? Maybe his forehand, but he has improved that shot. Maybe his speed. He's not the fastest player because of his height. But I should say that, man, this is hard. Who will win this match? It can go either way. Really, it can go either way. I really don't know. The player who has the best day, the player who will be the most consistent, the player who will take his opportunity most, he will win this match. Medvedev has a better serve than Dominic, in my opinion. Medvedev has better returns than Dominic. But Medvedev, I don't know if Medvedev has, if Medvedev is a better baseline player than Dominic. Dominic, he can really be steady from a baseline. Medvedev can be that as well. Dominic is easier hitting through than what Medvedev is. Look, I like both these guys, really. For me, whoever wins this match, I will be happy because they both deserve it. Really, they both deserve this victory. But considering all these things I've said, I think that this will be a battle, a serve and return battle. The player who will serve best, the player who will return best, will win this match. Dominic didn't drop his serve one single time against Djokovic. That was crazy to see because Djokovic is the best returner in the game. But Dominic was coming with big clutch serves in big moments against Djokovic. Will he do the same against Medvedev? Will he do the same? I don't know. Will Dominic play a second straight match in a row where he will not drop his serve in the entire match like he didn't do against Djokovic? I don't think so, man. I think that Medvedev is too good of a player to not break Dominic's serve one single time in the entire match. I think that Medvedev is a better server than Dominic Thiem. I don't think that Medvedev is a more consistent player than Dominic Thiem in the entire match. I think that Dominic can be more consistent than Medvedev. Medvedev can take vacations like he did against Nadal, both in the first set and in the middle of the second set. Medvedev can take vacations. I don't think that Dominic takes that quite of vacations like Medvedev can do during his matches. But I feel that Medvedev is on a streak here. I feel that Medvedev is looking unstoppable. He just won Paris Masters a couple of weeks ago. I had Medvedev as my number one pick before the event started. I went against Medvedev against Nadal. I went against him against Nadal. I said Nadal would defeat Medvedev in three sets, 2-1. Medvedev proved me wrong in that match. But Medvedev has not proved me wrong when I picked him to win the tournament 1 week ago, when I had him as my number one player. And he's in the final now. He's in the final now. Exactly like I thought 1 week ago, even though that I went against him in the semifinal against Nadal. He proved me wrong there. Kudos to Medvedev there. But I think that Medvedev will frustrate Dominic Thiem. Dominic will go for his shots. Dominic will pull the trigger. Dominic will unleash those heavy, deep ground strokes that he has. But I think that Medvedev will squeeze a lot of unforced errors from Dominic Thiem. I think so. I think that Medvedev will return better than Dominic Thiem. I think that Medvedev will serve better than Dominic Thiem. I will give Daniil Medvedev 51% winning chances and Dominic Thiem 49% winning chances. So I will say Medvedev wins this battle in three sets. I will say this. I will not be surprised at all if Dominic proves me wrong. I truly would not be surprised at all. For God's sakes, Dominic Thiem has defeated both Nadal and Novak Djokovic in this tournament, the world number two and the world number one. And Daniil Medvedev, he has defeated also the same players. He has defeated both Nadal, the world number two, and Novak Djokovic, the world number one. But I feel that Daniil Medvedev is in a hot streak here. He's playing probably the same kind of brutal tennis as he did 14, 15 months ago when he had that hot streak with 6-7 straight finals in that run he had last year. And he has not lost one single match so far in this tournament. And I think that he will defeat Dominic Thiem in 3 sets. I'm not saying this with super sky-high confidence. I'm not saying that. But I have, when I think and analyzed all these things, serves, returns, who is harder hitting through? Of course, Medvedev is harder hitting through than Dominic is. But the only thing, if Dominic wins this match, he will do it by outpowering Daniil Medvedev, out-hitting Daniil Medvedev, and he can do that. If it's somebody who can out-hit and outpower Daniil Medvedev, it is for sure Dominic Thiem, without shadow of a doubt. But the question will be, will Dominic Thiem, will he be able to hold those unforced errors down? He held them down against Djokovic, but he did steal 39 unforced errors. And he did 50 winners. That is a lot. That is a lot. But can he do the same match again like he did with Djokovic? And Djokovic is not in his prime of his career, guys. He's not. And Djokovic almost defeated Dominic Thiem. He almost did. Let's be honest here. Let's face it. He almost did. He was up in the lead in the tiebreak for love. So I will go with Daniil Medvedev here. I will go with him. He looks unstoppable. He looks so difficult to hit him through. He has that serve. He has that returns. He doesn't have the same firepower as Dominic Thiem. He's not as consistent from a baseline as Dominic Thiem. He takes more vacations than Dominic Thiem. Dominic Thiem, he has become super consistent, super solid during his matches. So I will not be surprised. I will not be shocked at all if Dominic Thiem wins. Absolutely not. That's why I give Medvedev my slightly edge with 51% winning chances and Dominic Thiem with 49% winning chances. And I will say Daniil Medvedev wins this one 2-1. I will say that. So I think that Daniil Medvedev wins this ATP Tour's finals in London in 3 sets. But of course, I will not be surprised at all if Dominic instead proved me wrong. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed this 33 minutes long final preview. Enjoy the match and may the best player win. Take care and bye bye.